Well, good morning once again. You know, it's always wonderful to be away from Washington, D.C., and particularly when you can spend a week in Alaska. And I've enjoyed my week in Alaska, and it's wonderful to be here. But it's wonderful to be here, particularly this morning, discussing Arctic issues with the world leaders and subject matter experts who are most devoted to these issues. First of all, I'm grateful to all of you for attending. But I'm also grateful to the many staff members from the State Department, the White House, and the interagency in Washington who've worked so hard behind the scenes to present this conference here in Anchorage. I'm also grateful to the Alaskans who've made us feel so welcome. And I hope all of you who were at the reception last night at the Anchorage Museum enjoyed yourselves. I know I certainly did. And there was one moment when I was walking through the crowd last night as I arrived, and I was listening to all the many languages being spoken in the little sidebar discussions as I went across the room. It reminded me of another significant international event that occurred during my career as an officer in the Coast Guard. Nearly two decades ago, I sailed my ship along with over 100 of the other of the world's tall ships to St. Petersburg, Russia, for a celebration of the 300th anniversary of the Russian fleet. Now, during one of the evenings in St. Petersburg, a large group of ship captains gathered in the grand cabin of Ireland's tall ship, Asgard II. We got together for an evening of camaraderie and fellowship, and I suspect a few sea stories to be told as well. And during that night, as I scanned the room in the cabin, I observed sailors speaking in Russian, English, Spanish, Portuguese, Danish, Arabic, and several other languages. Now, in spite of our cultural differences, and obviously our language differences, it seemed as though we understood each other. I suspect that's because as sailors, we shared a common purpose and a common language. In our case, the language of the sea. When I was interviewed by a reporter the next day, I related my experience, and when asked what I had learned from the event, without thinking twice, I said, "I think if everybody in the world was a sailor, we could solve all the world's problems." Now, there's some truth to that statement. Being a sailor requires the ability to communicate across boundaries and differences in order to get a job done. As captains that evening in St. Petersburg, talking with sailors from across the globe, we drew upon our shared purpose and our collective understanding of the sea in order to speak in a common language. Now, over the years, I've often thought about that visit to St. Petersburg. But I've also learned over the years that solving the world's problems requires all of us, statesmen, policymakers, diplomats, scientists, politicians, business people, and yes, a few sailors as well. But now as a shorebound sailor at the State Department, I understand even more deeply how a common purpose and shared goals can create a shared language among people from around the world. The man I'm introducing today has always understood and embodied that lesson. During his 28 years in the United States Senate, he was known for his ability to compromise, broker compromises and agreements among his peers. And he was always able to find common ground among groups with disparate views, allowing meaningful policies to move forward. As our Secretary of State, he's been even more effective in forging shared goals and priorities among a wide variety of stakeholders and countries. In fact, it's because of his leadership that the world is here today in Alaska to speak in the common language of the Arctic. Secretary Kerry is committed to our shared goals of addressing climate change, protecting the world's oceans, and promoting Arctic issues. He's brought us here together to listen to one another so that together we can create a common language to talk about this very important and culturally rich place. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to introduce a policymaker, a statesman, a diplomat, and yes, a sailor as well, the Secretary of State of the United States, John Kerry.